Fire Escape by Leah Evans. Act 1. An apartment at the street below. It is quiet, but not for long. Lainey appears on the street carrying a bag, a guitar case with big letters on it, names, initials, quotes, and pictures. She pushes the dial on her cell phone, waits, tries again, same result.
David? Right then. David! 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 David!
David rushes into the apartment, struggling to hold his laundry, mail, and other items.
Crap! Oh, hey, I'm coming! I am coming! Hold on! I'm coming.
I was supposed to be there 15 minutes ago.
I know. I am sorry. I'm coming. I'm just running just a little bit behind schedule.
Understatement of the century.
I heard that.
Funny how you hear that and not your alarm.
Yeah, I know. I'm sorry.
No rush.
No rush? It's my friend's first big show. I wouldn't miss it for the world. Consider me doubly rushed.
Considered.
Detached from the scene, wrapped up in their own lives and conversations, other characters enter. Keeley in her barista apron and Fallon in her proper lawyer attire.
What do you think? I think it's too dark. I mean, I asked for mocha brown. This isn't mocha. It's like a deep cocoa. This isn't what I wanted, but I didn't have the heart to just be like, Denise, this isn't mocha. And unfortunately, my hair looks like crap.
Crap, Norman, crap. Do you think that I was born yesterday? Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Yeah. No, Norman, enough, all right? I want the files on my desk tomorrow. You got it? Listen, I've got Daniel on the other line, and I still have to put in the order for my dress. Think you can manage this by yourself? Oh, crap, Norman, enough!
Enough panicking. He'll like it, and that's all that matters. If you think about it, all hair is like a decoration. It's a head decoration. And Damien's such a great guy. He loves me for who I am. So there's really no point to all of this worrying, right? Right? Oh, God!
God, I know we haven't spoken in a while, but that doesn't mean I haven't been thinking about you. Please, 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 please grant me this one miracle of David hauling ass downstairs in the next 10 seconds so for once we can actually be on time. Amen.
I hear you praying down there.
Daniel appears on his own phone, disheveled in a dress shirt.
I don't look good in tuxes, Fallon. I look like I'm going to a bar mitzvah.
When have you ever been to a bar mitzvah?
I haven't.
Then how would you know?
I don't know, I guess. I just imagine that's how the poor kids would look.
I don't think they wear tuxes to those things, hon.
I said imagine, baby.
Phil, David's best guy friend, comes into view. Picking up ladies, the usual.
Hey, babe. What do you say the two of us get out of here and go back to my place?
How about I imagine up some dinner this evening?
Tonight, it's about you and me. A beautiful woman like you shouldn't be at a bar all alone.
He's great. I mean, he really is. He isn't like other guys. He treats me so well. And he always brings me flowers on all of our dates. He's a real catch.
Don't tell me that you don't feel it. The spark between the two of us. I've only known you for a little while, but I already feel like I know you. You get me?
He has a kid, but it's not like a deal breaker. You know, I mean, I've only met him once or twice, and he's an absolute sweetheart. The kid, not the father. That'd be weird.
I want to get to know you better. All right, well, let's get out of here.
That was awful.
What was?
You trying to be suave.
Sorry.
No. It was cute. Just wasn't suave. But if I wanted suave, I wouldn't have said yes to you in the first place.
Now, I'm not sure if I should be offended or complimented.
Yes? No?
Both.
All right. Drinks on me, everybody.
So after this whole tux fiasco, Dinner?
Depending on what I have to do in the next few hours, maybe.
Or drinks. Drinks on these guys over there.
Maybe.
Maybe.
Maybe after work, I can just tuck it under a hat and he won't notice. What am I saying? Of course he'll notice. Listen, I don't mean to sound like a complete crazy because I'm not, honest.
Cal, a young Muslim man, appears at his socks. He is speaking to an invisible patron.
There are mice. There are mice running all over my mosque.
Jerks.
Now, I don't want to rush you or anything, but it's very difficult to get a steady following when you have vermin running all over prayer mats. It's hard enough being new. They aren't that eager for new blood, let alone one guy called me baby. Me. Do I look like a baby? Oh, geez, I look like a baby.
Are you even listening?
Listen, I realize that you are very busy, but I paid you 2 weeks ago for your services, and the mice have pretty much turned this place into an amusement park. Now I'm asking you very nicely.
Who am I kidding? I sound like a raving lunatic. I wouldn't listen to me either.
So are you gonna get it done this weekend? Please?
Oh, no, 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 no!
Okay then, maybe some other time.
Just you and me.
Throw the keys down!
I want you.
What?
Throw the damn keys down!
Come on, let's leave now before we sober up.
I'm coming down.
No?
Thank God!
I just have one more thing to do.
Come on, what can you possibly have to do still?
Oh, should I just call someone else?
Screw waiting.
Lainey grabs her bag of guitar, walks off as David hurries back into view.
The perfect solution. No one's happy.
Cal slides on his shoes and leaves. At the apartment, the phone rings again and again. David ignores it.
Okay, I got this. Bring this. Where is my wallet?
Oh, sorry.
Your loss.
My fault entirely.
You don't know what you're missing.
Daniel is now trying on suits.
Yes, Norman. I have a problem with someone on my own staff not being able to work on his own without me, holding his hand like some sort of child.
Fallon!
I'm not being childish, am I?
No.
Fallon!
One second. Norman, you're a freaking child.
Or, I bet you're easy anyways.
It's normal to worry like I do. Right?
No.
Fuck. I wish you were easy.
In a way, it occupies me. It keeps me busy. So maybe it's okay to worry about the little things, because then I don't have time to worry about the big things.
It'll be just fine.
The apartment phone rings until finally David has to answer it. Silence. His face falls.
Won't it?
Blackout. Act 1, Scene 1. David's apartment, dark. A lump of blankets sits on the couch. Outside of the apartment stands a wooden crate. Lainey enters, carrying her guitar case as well as her bag. She is speaking up towards David's window, which is, in this case, the audience.
David? David! Rise and shine, buddy! David, it's me! It's Lainey! What am I saying? Of course you know it's me. Who else would stand down here yelling at you like some sort of... I don't know. You up there? You don't think I'm mad about missing your show, do you? Because I'm not. David, you've got to come down there eventually. It's been 4 months. It's not like you could stay up there forever. I mean, you could, but it wouldn't be any fun. At least throw the keys down so I can come up. All right, then. Like McDonald says, have it your way.
She gets up and picks up the crate, bringing it back to the center of the street. She sits on it, but she takes out her guitar.
I'm done playing nice, David. I tried knocking. I tried buzzing up. You won't budge. We played by your terms for months now, and we're gonna play on mine. From now on, I'm gonna be here all day. All day, Dave. This is my new 9-to-5 job. Heck, it's my first 9-to-5. Crazy world, huh? Well, I'm all stocked up on snacks, and there's a bathroom in the back room at the grocery store, so I'm all set. It's just a matter of playing the waiting game. Unless you want to throw down the keys and save us both the trouble. All right, then. Don't say I didn't warn you. Prepare yourself. It's an all-day marathon of Hey There, Delilah. Hey there, Delilah.
The lights fade out on her melody as it carries into David's apartment. Scene 2. Inside David's empty apartment, some old comedy show is heard, like I Love Lucy. Audience laughter comes from the set. A lump of blankets sits on the couch. Door opens to reveal Daniel, who has a grocery bag under one arm, papers, and the apartment keys in the other. He steps in quietly, leaving the door open.
Dave? Dave! I brought the groceries you wanted. $68.32. Pay me back whenever you can. Just don't tell Fallon. She'd strangle me. I'm supposed to be saving up for the reception. I also brought some papers that you should look at. Whenever you have the time. Am I talking to myself here?
Phil, David's best friend, appears in the doorway. He has a half-empty beer bottle in hand.
What up, cunts?
Hello, Phil.
Hey, how you doing, buddy boy? Come here.
Fine. What are you doing here?
I was out drinking last night.
I see you haven't stopped.
It's all about the endurance, man. Like how marathon runners run laps. You gotta start slow, then speed up and win the race. But after you gotta go into a slow jog and keep from cramping up. Endurance.
Since when do you care about marathons?
Not a damn bit. Oh, shit. But if it gets hot girls into spandex short shorts, then I am so pro marathons.
Right. That sounds like the Phil I know.
And love. Am I right? Ah, man, that's right. That's right. You're into the whole powerful, independent woman thing. Equality or some Susan B. Antoinette bullshit like that.
What? Phil, Susan B. Anthony and Marie Antoinette are...
Okay, I get it. You'll grow out of it. Trust me, dude.
Whatever you say.
Oh, God. I remember you were dating that girl. What was her name?
Fallon?
Yeah! Yeah, that's the bitch! Don't get me wrong. She was a hottie and all, but a serious fucked bitch. Come on. I totally always found it weird that she was interested in a guy like you. She had to get a little something said, you know what I mean?
Phil, we're engaged.
What? For reals?
The realist.
Oh, since when?
For nearly 2 years.
Ah, oh, man. Really? To Fallon?
Yes.
Well, good fucking luck.
Thank you.
I'm sure she's gotten better. Her bitch level's probably at a 6 at tops.
No, oh, thank you, Phil. How'd you get in here?
Well, Dave gave me a copy of the key. I'm his best bro. You know what it's like having friends, don't you, Danny boy? Or does Fallon keep you on a short leash?
Best bro or not, I don't think it's wise for you to have a key when you don't even live here.
Why not?
Because you're Phil.
Daniel moves across the room to check the other rooms for David. Phil follows in pursuit.
Hey, very funny, fuckface. You've got a key.
I'm his bro. His real bro. That's why I have one.
That hurts, man. Really. That cuts deep.
Then why are you laughing?
Because you said it, bro. I mean, it sounds funny when you try and say it is all.
Yeah, it's because you're drunk. That's why.
And why you gotta hate on me?
I'm not hating on anyone. Where is my brother?
You're hating on me.
I am most certainly not hating on you, Philip. Even though if I was to have any resentment towards you, I'd have a very good reason.
Oh yeah? Like what?
This whole conversation, for starters. Please just stop messing around and tell me where David is.
Danny, stop fronting. Stop fronting that hate, stop fronting that you hate me.
Front what?
You don't have to pretend that you hate me.
Who's pretending?
You never used to hate me. Not till Queen Bitch decided she did. Then you did. But she's not here, Danny boy. You can say or feel whatever or however you want. I ain't gonna tell on you. We're not in the Boy Scouts anymore, even though you fucking act like you're in it.
Phil, if you could please just...
All right. I know that you find me a freaking adorable.
Yeah, sure. That's the word for it.
And besides, if you hated me, you wouldn't be wearing the shirt I got you last Christmas.
Laundry day.
Is every Thursday laundry day?
What?
You wear that shirt every Thursday. The Thursdays I've seen you anyway. That's your Thursday shirt.
I most certainly do not have a Thursday shirt.
I see you're rocking it with your Friday socks. Wistful for the weekend?
Philip, I don't have time for your games right now.
Oh, shut up. I use the word wistful. You know you're impressed. Hell, I'm impressed. Wistful.
I regret getting you that word a day calendar.
He's not going to leave.
I'm not trying to get him to.
You're so full of it.
I'm not full of anything. I just want to talk.
You're so full of shit. You come here over every week and you do the same thing.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
He said no last week. He said no last month. He's still going to say no now. It ain't going to be any different.
Maybe it will.
Well,
it has to be.
Why?
You know why.
Listen, I know that you're the guy with the college degree and shit, but you're wrong this time. 4 months, dude.
I know.
Since Damien died. And I'm sorry, man. I really am, but he's been up here since then.
I know.
Living off ramen noodles and his savings.
I know that. Of course I know that.
He doesn't want the kid, Danny.
He does. He just doesn't know it.
Are you serious now? Who the fuck thinks like that? That's a real fucking Disney way of looking at things, Danny. Real fucking great. So what if he says yes to taking the kid in? Then what, huh? Cue some Randy Newman and bring in the fucking animal friends?
You curse an awful lot.
Fuck yeah, I do.
It's not going to be that way, Phil.
It's the damn truth. For some reason, I seem to be the only one out of all of you supposedly smart people to know.
Well, I think that I'd know my own brother, Phil.
Do you? He's not going to leave this apartment. Nothing you do or say is going to be any different than what you did or said last week, or the week before, or the week before that. Nothing is going to change.
Then why are you here?
Cold beer.
Where's Dave?
Besides you, I'm the only person that comes here. I'm like his fucking bridge to the outside world.
That's reassuring.
I'm London fucking Bridge.
And everyone knows what happened to London Bridge.
What? Dude, shut up!
Just tell me where he is, Phil.
He went out to catch a flick. Where the hell do you think he is? He's here.
I understand that, Phil, but I meant where in the general area of this apartment is he?
Okay, I see how it is. You ready for this? You ready to have your mind fucking blown? I can wait because you don't look ready. Ah, there we go, there it is. Now you're ready, okay. Here we go. Abra fucking cadabra.
Phil pulls aside the lump of blanket on the couch to reveal David, who has been lying beneath it the entire time.
Would you guys just be quiet, please?
Thank you, thank you. I accept all major credit cards, credit, debit.
Right. Very funny. Why didn't you answer when I was calling for you?
Oh, no. Dad's mad.
Who turned off the TV?
David turns on the television, but Daniel promptly turns it off.
Dad's mad.
Why didn't you answer?
Because I was sleeping. I heard you, all right? 6, 8:32. Don't tell Fallon. And I shouldn't have given Phil a key because he's a bad friend.
I knew it!
I didn't say that. I just meant that it's probably not the best idea to give him a key.
Now I'm a bit tipsy. But I should be insulted, right?
No.
Yeah.
I knew it.
It's not what I meant.
God damn it, man. Wistful. I use the word wistful.
All right, can I have a moment alone with my brother?
You're kicking me out? Little Danny boy is kicking me out?
Just into the next room.
Are you guys gonna get all gay and touchy and shit?
Possibility.
Minute it is. Shit! When'd you get a Sega?
You have a real way with him.
Yeah, well, I see him enough. Not nearly as often when you two live together, but still way too much. So, Fallon told me not to, but I figured I'd bring you this.
Oh, no. Queen Bitch told him not to.
It's an invitation to the wedding.
2 months? It's in 2 months?
Well, yeah, well, after everything that happened, we decided not to drag it out any longer. Her words.
Yeah, I figured, but when did you decide to reschedule?
Monday.
How did she even get these printed so quickly?
It's Fallon. Whatever she wants, she sets her mind to, and she gets it done.
Stop saying that name in this house!
I was actually wondering if, well, if you'd be willing to be my best man. You don't have to answer right away. Fallon said I shouldn't bug you, but, you know, I just wanted to ask.
Me? It's not a whole lot of notice.
I know. I realize it's cutting it close.
Yeah, I'll say.
We don't want to wait anymore.
Are you sure it's we?
Yes. We. I want to be married, David. We've postponed this more than once, and with everything that's been going on, she's been more than agreeable about it, which for her is saying a whole lot, and it's time. We want our families there. If anything, we need that now more than ever. Come on. Please, I'd really like it if my big brother would be my best man.
Was that your first choice?
What?
You said you'd like it if your big brother was your best man.
David,
You used to have two of them, you know.
I know. Dave, Damien's death has been hard for everyone. Really hard, but you can't keep yourself shut in like you've been doing. It's not healthy.
Oh, are you a doctor now?
A what?
A doctor?
No.
No, you're not.
But I do know that being locked up in this apartment isn't helping. It's making it worse. How's anything going to get better if you're just staying put in this?
You're a teacher, right?
Yes.
Of what?
David, please.
Of what?
English lit.
Yeah, I thought so. And,
But that doesn't mean that...
English lit, not psychology. You're not a doctor, and I'm not one of your high school kids, so don't lecture me like it.
Dad's mad!
All right.
All right.
Phil re-enters with his phone.
I gotta head out, guys. This girl I met last night, smoking hot. I'm telling you, perfect 10. Well, she just called and wants to grab drinks. Your buddy Phil's getting laid tonight. Come on, give me a little love. All right, then. Later, chodes. Hails to the fucking yes.
He doesn't have a date, does he? I should go. Fallon and I are going to dinner if you want to come. Well, you think on it. Oh, I brought some papers. Fallon did her whole lawyer thing and looked him over. You just have to sign on a few lines and then they come over for a house check and a pretty extensive interview. And well, they've been really nice about the whole thing. The lady's a friend of Mom and Dad, so she's been pretty understanding.
For
Aiden.
Oh, okay.
Dave, you can't just pretend he doesn't exist and go away.
The approach has been working pretty well so far. I mean, well, for everyone except you.
Very funny, David, but life doesn't work like that.
And life isn't fair. Life doesn't always go the way you want it to. I know all the cliches. I get it.
Not to be a nag, Dave, but I don't think you do.
You know, well, you're being a nag, Dan.
This isn't just a problem, David. This is Aiden. This is a little boy.
That's just it. I'm his uncle. I'm not his dad.
His dad is gone. Damien's gone, and Aiden is all alone. And he's just as upset as you are.
I haven't seen the kid in months.
He loves you.
You don't know that.
I do. And I know that you love him. Dave, come on. We always had to pry you two apart.
Yeah, after school and before bed. It's definitely father material.
You'd be a great father. Damien knew that.
Is Aiden still with you?
Yeah. He's a great kid. He really is.
Then why don't you just keep him? He likes you, right? I mean, he must.
Because Damien's wish, his last wish, was that you would take care of him, and you know that.
Every week you come over, and every week it's the same thing. I mean, you play nice, and then you follow it up with paperwork and a kid, and it's like, it's that easy. It's not. I'm not ready.
Well, you can't just put a kid on reserve and pick him up whenever you feel like it.
Just don't start.
His mom's gone. His dad's gone.
I know that. Of course I know that.
He picked you. Out of everyone, he picked you.
I don't know what he was thinking.
He was thinking that you would have been the best choice. It's what Damien wanted.
I don't know how to play daddy.
It's not like anyone does. It's something you learn with time.
And how would you know that? Is it something you read in one of your books?
No, but I just assume.
Don't assume anything. How could you assume something like that?
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to.
Oh, maybe that's something you've magically picked up in a few months you've had the kid?
I don't know. Maybe.
Okay. I mean, then who am I to stop you and Fallon from playing at home? Huh? Am I right?
Excuse me?
Our big brother is dead, and you're too wrapped up in your makeshift family crap that you don't even care.
Of course I care. Now you're being ridiculous. We postponed the wedding twice. Fallon has been very understanding these past few months.
Oh, well, then all hell, Queen Fallon, then. Clearly, anything she says means more to you than how I feel.
That's not true. You're not being fair.
But then how exactly would you like me to act, Dan?
Sorry.
Yeah? Well, maybe I'm sick of you being so damn sorry. I'm sick of having to hear it over and over and over and over. I get it. So stop talking at me all the goddamn time.
Daniel is quiet. He goes to the door, stops, changes his mind, and instead...
Lainey's outside. You might want to buzz her up.
Daniel exits. David walks towards the couch, plopping down, picks up the remote and turns on the TV set. Audience laughter is heard, and then some old-time show, like I Love Lucy. Scene 3. The street below. It's getting late. Lainey gives it one last shot for the night.
Hey, David! Dave! It's me! David! Dave! 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 David!
We hear you.
Knock it off, Phil! David?
He's not answering. Go away.
David, it's getting dark.
How do you not get this?
I have to go soon.
Oh, We'll make soon now.
Are you mad at me?
Go.
Did I do something?
Away.
Just talk to me. You know I hate being ignored more than anything. I have to know why. Just tell me.
Away. Go away. And oh yeah, who's on the phone? Oh, it's go away.
Why don't you let him answer for himself, Phil?
Maybe he doesn't want to.
Well, why don't you let him?
Why don't you just shut up and go home?
Oh, why don't you make me, dude?
I would, but the Yanks are up.
Oh yeah, who's up?
Yanks by 3 last time I checked, but I took a break to make hot pots.
What kind?
Ham and cheese. You want?
You got?
Daniel walks onto the street.
Any luck?
No. I'm afraid not.
Well, me neither.
Well, good night.
See ya.
Daniel goes to leave. He stops at the last moment and comes striding back.
Am I the only sane one here?
Oh, fuck. Is my microwave supposed to do that?
Probably.
This isn't normal. What he's doing up there is not normal. I know he's hurting. I get that. Trust me. I understand. But I understand more than most. And sure, I didn't live with him or even spend a ton of time up there with them, but I was still their brother, you know? I still am. Just because I couldn't be up there 24/7 doesn't mean I didn't want to be. They wouldn't let me. I was always too young. I was always too in the way. I was always too something. It's not my fault. And just because I wasn't as close as they were doesn't mean that I was his brother, too. I matter, too. I just always wanted so badly to be a part of what they had, and I'm well aware that I was not the brother that they wanted, but I wanted to be. God, I wanted to be. I would have done anything. Anything. It's all right. I'm all right. We're batting 1,000 here, Lainey.
Bill enters.
You can't bat 1,000, Danny boy.
I realize that no one is perfect.
No, I mean, it's impossible. If Bonds can't do it, you can't do it. And he was all roided up. Aren't you supposed to be smart? Here, bitch.
Thanks, Jode.
I will never understand you two.
I'll never understand math.
Want to know what I won't understand?
Not particularly.
You want David to leave, right?
I believe that's obvious. I've said it enough times.
Yeah, sure. All I heard was wham, wham, wham. Fallon said wham, wham, wham. But I don't see you doing a damn fucking thing.
Excuse me?
You want him to leave that apartment? Go upstairs, pick him up. Pay someone to go upstairs, pick him up, and throw him out. Or better yet, how about you stop buying him food like some sort of bitch?
Phil!
What? Your parents pay his rent, you buy him food, he just has to sit upstairs all day and watch TV. Everything and everyone else comes to him. I'd stay up there too, you adorable little enabler, you. Oh shit, there's another one. Enabler. That's from Tuesday. Sweet.
Bill exits. It's quiet.
Danny, just don't worry about him. It's Phil.
He's right.
What?
Phil is right.
No, I heard you. I've just never heard that he was right before. Are you going to stop?
No, I can't. I've already lost one brother. I'm not going to lose another.
Danny, he's lucky to have you.
And you. You heading home?
Yeah, for tonight anyways.
Be back tomorrow?
Yep. You?
I'm thinking I might take the day off tomorrow. That was a joke.
Oh. Haha.
Really wasn't funny at all, was it?
No, not really.
Go home!
I'm going, Philip.
See you soon, Danny.
Yeah. See you soon, Lainey.
Dave, Hot Pockets? You love Hot Pockets!
What a lame attempt. Nothing. Lainey shrugs to Daniel. The two go their separate ways. A Hot Pocket sails down from above and lands on the floor below with a thud. Scene 4. David's apartment. David sits on the couch watching television. Laughter. A soft knock on the door. David doesn't budge. Another few knocks. David does not budge. More short, yet rapid knocks. The third time's a charm and David rises. He moves to the door and opens it to reveal Cal, who is holding mail.
Hello. This was delivered to my apartment by mistake. I'm Cal. I live in the next door. I moved in this month. don't worry, I wouldn't remember me either. We briefly met, actually. Well, I more met your friend. I forgot his name. Real exaggerated fellow. Lots of big gestures. Very naked in my doorway. Well, either way, I caught a glimpse of you through the door, so I wasn't so much as meeting you as it was seeing, I suppose. Well, here you go. It's yours, I swear. How they got David Brennan confused with Capital, I'll never know. You're not much of a talker, are you?
David takes the mail and turns to go. Cal stops the door with his hand, still wishing to be in the picture, but not in the room unless invited.
Thanks.
Oh, not a problem, really.
Do you need something else?
No. No. Why would you say that? Oh, I apologize. I'll just be going.
You that Moss guy?
Oh, yes. I mean, technically the title is Imam, but yes, that's me.
I thought so. You seem surprised.
Surprised?
That I knew.
Oh, maybe a little bit.
Are you looking for something?
Not really something, more so investigating.
Find anything good?
Forgive me. I heard some of the other residents in the building talking.
People talk about me.
Oh, briefly.
I see. That's,
They said that you've been in here for quite a few months, that you haven't left. Not once. Is it true?
Yeah.
And you haven't gone out?
Nope.
Not once?
No.
Wow. I'm sorry for your loss, David.
Excuse me?
People talk.
Oh, well, you know, you don't need to be, right? I mean, you don't even know me. Heck, I don't know you.
Be it that as it may, I still am.
All right.
He's in a better place.
Yeah, people always say that.
Well, possibly because they believe it.
Oh, well, what do you believe?
Me? You
do believe in something, don't you?
Yes, I suppose.
I mean, you are an imam. You lead people with belief, so you technically have to believe in something.
I do. Okay. It's just that no one has ever asked me before.
No?
No, people more so expect me to believe in certain things.
Then what do you believe in?
Well, We believe that the death is actually just a starting of points of a man's life. Our actions will help help one's spirit to grow strong, and the good deed during one's life will be rewarded in the afterlife.
You believe that?
Yes, I suppose so.
Even if someone off themselves. People didn't talk about that, huh?
No. They failed to mention that, I'm afraid.
Yeah, so you see, people believe all sorts of things that they shouldn't.
No.
Excuse me?
I still believe what I said.
You do? Okay. Even if my brother did what he did.
My mother always taught me that a single act that doesn't harm another person shouldn't determine if a person is good or bad.
But it did harm people.
It was a mistake. Unfortunately, some mistakes have bigger consequences than others.
That is bold to say.
Yes. Wow. But you asked what I believe in.
And you told me. Mm. Hearing it from you doesn't really help at all.
This is true. And I'm still very sorry.
We're Catholic.
No, not everyone's perfect.
Thanks. Is that all?
Oh, yes. No. There's a young woman outside.
I know.
You saw her?
Yeah.
She's actually been out there a while. I saw her down there Sunday. Well, I heard her.
Yeah, she is pretty loud.
What is she doing out there?
Waiting.
For what?
Me, I assume.
You? Huh? She's your friend.
No.
Oh, all right.
She's my best friend.
Come again?
She's my best friend.
She's your best friend. And you're just gonna leave her out there?
I'm not leaving her anywhere. I mean, I didn't invite her.
But she's outside. She's right out there. And you're going to let her up, right?
No.
It'll be getting cold soon.
And then she'll go home.
She seems pretty persistent.
And she'll get tired eventually, and then she'll go home.
What if she doesn't?
Oh, but she will. They always do. Hmm. Is that all?
Oh, yes. No, please keep your boisterous friend away from my door. He frightens me.
He frightens everybody.
Then why do you keep him around? I better get going. I've intruded on you enough. It was nice meeting you, David.
Yeah, nice meeting you too.
Cal leaves. David is alone. He closes the door and sits on the couch. Reaching for the remote, he turns the television on. Laughter is heard from the television set. A series of light, frenzied knocks.
What do you want now? Please, come on.
Keeley stands in the doorway. David is clearly surprised by her presence and takes a moment to recover. Keeley looks a bit frazzled, having been yelled at.
Hi, David.
Keeley.
Did I come at a bad time?
No. What?
What? Well, you look like you just woke up, is all?
You didn't see him?
It's just, you said to stop by whenever I had time to pick up my things, and I just got off duty, and I had the time, so, surprise!
I told you that 6 months ago.
Surprise. Oh, I also brought his key back. I guess I've been putting off giving it back. That's silly, huh? Can I come in?
Well, you kind of have to if you want your stuff back.
Oh, yes. Yes. Well, that makes sense, doesn't it? as you can see, not much has changed since I've seen you last. Still a test.
David pulls out a big box labeled Damien. However, it gets stuck, so David struggles with it.
It's nice to see that some things stay the same, you know?
I'm not sure if that's a good or bad thing.
I mean, can it be both?
Keeley moves to help him.
You are still the same.
Oh, yeah, really?
Yeah, same, just not as outgoing. I mean, not outgoing at all, really, if you think about it. I mean, because you don't ever go out. No, you stay locked up in this here apartment day in and day out, on and on for 6 months. I mean, I know if it was me, I'd just about kill myself. Oh, my God. Oh, God, that sounded awful. Didn't it? I didn't mean it to. David, I'm so sorry.
It's okay.
I just keep talking and talking, and I never know when to stop, and all I do is babble on.
Really, it's okay. I don't mind. I like when you babble.
You do?
Yeah. On and on and on and on and on.
Yep. Still the same David.
The box is finally freed.
Well, this should be everything.
It's a lot of stuff. I never realized.
I put a few of the shirts you got him in there. There's letters too. If you want, you can go and take another look around the room. But it's kind of empty now.
It's okay. I trust you.
I put all of his pictures in there too. I figured you'd want those.
Thank you.
She begins to dig through the box.
Oh, so what are you doing?
What do you think I'm doing, silly goose? I'm looking to see what's in here.
Yeah, great. Can you do that somewhere else?
Look! I never thought I would see this again!
I mean it's just a bear. So, you know.
Oh my gosh, and these are pictures that I drew on his receipt when he used to come into the coffee shop.
Not bad, really. The penguin's a tad bit hippie, though.
No, shush, it is not.
There's a picture of the three of us in there somewhere.
Oh, is there really?
Yeah, back when he and I first moved in.
Keeley finds the picture and marvels at it.
Oh gosh, look at that brown hair. Oh, I look like a mess.
I think you look great.
Well, thanks, but you have to say that, so.
No, I mean it. I mean, why would I have to say something like that?
I'm sorry, David. I had another bad audition today. They said I wasn't tall enough.
Oh, well, I mean, next time then?
Next time my hair will be too red, or I'll be too fat or too skinny. I'll just be too something.
I mean, maybe you're just too pretty.
Thanks. Oh, gosh. Aiden looks so tiny in this photo. I mean, how old was he here? Like 4? Look at him.
Yeah, I saw. That was right before Damien started seeing you.
Oh, he's getting so big. And sometimes I just can't believe it.
I mean, kids tend to do that, Keeley.
I know that. Everyone knows that. It's just... When you look at this picture, I mean, wowzers.
David notices her left hand.
You're still wearing the ring.
Oh, yes, I guess I am. I know it's silly and all, I can't seem to find the heart to take it off. It's not every day you get an engagement ring, you know? I mean, it's not every day you fall in love.
No, it's not.
Kind of a special thing, you know?
It isn't silly. I mean, you wear that until you're ready to take it off.
Yeah.
Listen, Keeley, anytime you feel like, I don't know, talking, you can always come and visit.
I would like that. I mean, I'd say the same to you, but you never leave your...
It's all right. It's... you aren't going to try to make me leave right now?
No. You'll do it when you're ready.
Scene 5. Leaning on her crate, she is picking through the contents of a paper bag when she comes across a receipt.
Say, David, remember when those little chocolate milks used to be a quarter? Back during school? Man, those were the days. Now these things cost nearly 50 cents. Can you believe that? That's gotta be inflation, am I right? Okay, silent treatment still, I get that. But you totally know that I'm not gonna go anywhere. I mean, out of anything, you gotta know that. I'm a stubborn ass, Dave. You know that. It was practically my nickname all through college. Well, what I remember from college, anyways. The few days I remember were fan-fucking-tastic. At least, I think they were. Weren't they? Oh, you have to admit that you need me, Dave. You always need your best friend. You need your friends even if you don't necessarily know it yet. But that's what I'm here for. To remind you, I'm here to wait this little mess out once you figure out how stupid it is. That's what friends are for. Well, that and borrowing things you don't plan on returning.
Lainey sits back down and proceeds to drum on her thighs and hum to herself. A case of ADHD for sure. Behind her, Cal walks out holding a plastic container to his chest like a baby. He seems hesitant. He takes a step toward her, then thinks better of it. He moves to go. He stops himself. Turning back around, he deliberates for another few moments before clearing his throat. Lainey turns around.
Hi.
Hello.
Lainey turns back around, having done her part. Cal stands there, awkwardly. Another inner dilemma. Cal steps. He hesitates. Turns back around. Turns to face her. He resembles a young child having to go to the bathroom in a way from how he squirms. All at once, the words come out somewhat higher pitched, as though he just hit puberty.
My name's Cal.
Oh. Hi.
You're Lainey, right?
Yeah, that's me. How did you...
Your friend David told me when I was...
David?
Yeah, he lives next door.
Hey, David.
Yeah, you see, he...
He knows I'm here.
Mm-hmm. Mentioned that in passing, really.
Oh my god, great! Yes, that is great!
She hugs Cal, who immediately tenses, his plastic container squashed into his chest.
Is it?
Yes! He knows I'm here! That means it's only a matter of time.
Until what?
Until he throws down the keys and he lets me come up.
And that's important to you?
Yeah.
Why?
Don't know.
There has to be a reason.
Just is.
Just is?
Uh-huh.
I brought this for you. I thought you might be hungry since you've been down here for so long.
What is it?
Nothing bad, I swear. Just peppers. I brought a little bread down, too.
With a side of poison, maybe?
No. Is that what you think? No, of course not. That's just...
No offense. I don't really know you, so forgive me if I find the whole gift offering thing a little bit suspicious. Like forensic file style shit.
That's understandable. But I assure you, it's completely...
What?
Nothing. I think it's very admirable of you.
What is?
You waiting for your friend like you are.
How do you know about that?
Well, I live in the building and you're not exactly quiet, are you?
Oh, sorry.
No, nothing to apologize for. If you want to apologize to someone, go upstairs and apologize to Miss Albert. She is less than thrilled.
I don't know her.
No. Of course not. Why would you? Silly me.
So, is running a mosque exciting?
Hmm?
I heard you on the payphone talking to a what would you call it, customer, client?
Patron?
Yeah, one of those. On the payphone over there, most religious leaders I know use their own phones.
How many religious leaders do you know?
Oh, two priests and my friend's rabbi. Pretty much the whole start of a joke. Which brings the grand total to four, counting you, all of which have their own phones, except for you.
Well, the electricity is down in my mosque and we're a bit behind on the rent.
Oh, I guess that happens sometimes.
That it does. Listen, if you're hungry later, maybe we can go get something to eat. At the corner store, my treat.
Can't.
Still going to be waiting for your friend?
Yeah.
Maybe after then.
Buddy, I think it's going to be a while.
I'll wait then.
Huh?
I'll wait for you then.
When I said a while, I meant more than 10 minutes.
I know.
You have a job.
Don't you?
No, I've got a trust fund.
Oh, well, I can certainly visit before and after temple.
Why?
Just to keep you company. You look lonely. Unless you'd rather, I'd just go.
I don't have an extra crate. And I'm not giving you mine.
Oh, that's fine. I'll stand. I do it all day anyways.
Well, all right.
You have got to be kidding me. You're multiplying now?
The two remain in awkward silence for a few moments.
What is it? In your container, I mean.
Shamarah. That means hot pepper dip. It's my mother's recipe.
I prefer burgers.
Scene 6. David's apartment. David and Keeley are seated on the couch. The sound of laughter from the set. They are watching some old-timey show like I Love Lucy.
I love this show.
It's great, huh?
Yeah, I used to watch it all the time with my dad. Lucy's like my favorite character ever. She's so funny. Ah, what is that actress's name again?
Lucy?
Oh. Well, yes, that would make sense.
Okay. And Lucille Ball, my first crush.
What? Uh-huh. No way. You're kidding, really?
What? I mean, what's wrong with that? She's an independent, strong-willed woman. I mean, that is sexy.
And a redhead.
There you go, see? You get it.
A quiet knock on the door. David moves to the door and it opens, revealing Cal.
Excuse me, David.
Cal, can I help you?
Do you have any disposable cups?
Huh?
Oh, 1 second. We can fix it. I can edit it.
Cool.
Yeah, everyone's doing great. Oh no. Adam, do you want to leave and come back? Oh. Do. Everyone's doing great. I'm just gonna write in the chat. Technical difficulties. Oh, here we go.
Did I finish my beer? Or?
No, here we go.
So sorry.
No, not your fault. Technology.
Where would you like to go from?
A quiet knock on the
door.
David moves to the door and it opens, revealing Cal.
Excuse me, David.
Cal? Can I help you?
Do you have any disposable cups?
Huh?
I was going to bring some lemonade outside, and I discovered that I don't have any disposable cups.
Yeah, sure.
David moves away from the door to fetch some cups for Cal.
Cal, this is Keeley. Keeley, Cal. He just moved in next door.
A few months ago, actually.
A few months ago, apparently.
Hello, Cal.
Hi. Cups, David. I need cups.
Oh, right. Yeah. Sorry. One second. What do you need cups for anyway?
Oh, no reason.
David!
Cups!
Cal?
Hmm? Oh, yes. Thank you.
Anytime.
What? Really?
Really what?
You said any time.
Yeah, I did.
And you meant that?
Yeah, why wouldn't I mean that?
Oh. Thank you, David. That's very kind.
Oh, well, David's always been a real nice guy.
Yes, well, she's very pretty.
Yeah. Yeah?
Yes, and you know it.
Cal?
Yes.
She likes guys who state their opinion, even if she doesn't agree with them.
What? Who?
Oh no, David, did you abduct my recruit?
Oh, that who? Mm. Really, she does?
Yep, a whole lot.
You sure?
She's my best friend, I know. She'll like you for sure.
I don't care if she likes me.
Yeah, you do, and you know it.
David closes the door.
He seems nice.
He is.
You have good friends, Dave.
Moscai! Hey! Yo! Hey, me, where you going?
Could you please step aside?
Have a beer.
No, thank you.
Come on, Moscai.
Please put me down.
Hey, David. Moscai's are like super light.
Knock it off, Phil.
Yes, knock it off, Phil, please.
Aw, oh, man. So cool. I am never putting you down.
Please put me down, Phil.
Put him down, Phil.
Put him down, Phil. Just lucky, I guess.
Want to watch another episode?
Yeah, I think I'd like that.
Scene 7. The street. Lainey is seated on her crate. Cal comes rushing out backwards, defending himself from some unseen force.
No, that's perfectly all right. Please don't feel obligated to...
Is something wrong?
What? No, 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 of course not. Everything is fine.
You don't look fine.
I am fine. Perfectly fine.
You're shaking.
I'm excited.
Excited?
To be spending time with you.
Nice, but I don't buy it. What's going on?
Are we playing hide and seek now? Come on, I'm too hungover for games right now, man. Where'd you go?
Phil.
It's not a big deal.
Figures.
Really, it's fine.
He's picking on you, huh?
I can handle it.
He's such an idiot sometimes.
I've been through worse.
All the time.
Everything is fine, perfectly. Under control.
Phil enters from behind Cal and lifts him up with ease.
I am in control.
Yeah.
Yeah, really looks like it.
What do I win?
We're not playing a game.
Put him down, Phil.
Why don't you make me?
Do it or I'll yell your middle name for the whole world to hear.
You wouldn't.
Try me.
Fine. You win this round, crazy Lainey.
Yeah, that never gets old. Put the man down, Phil. I'm sorry, pee dog.
And there we go.
Phil sets Cal down.
There. Your precious mom, douche, is safe.
Yeah, thanks. Now get out of here.
Whatever, crazy Lainey. I'll just go back upstairs. You know, like a normal person.
You live in the same damn apartment, Phil, across the freaking hall.
I know that, dude. I know where I fucking live.
Go!
You're not on the street. Maybe I'll just stay here for as long as I fucking want. All right, fine. You got me. Fine. Just shut up, dude.
Phil exits. It's quiet.
Listen, don't pay Phil any attention. He's an ass. He's always been that way since college. Apparently David is only allowed one best friend and it's some breach of bro code or something. Even though I was around first. It's stupid. Are you okay?
He drank the lemonade in front of me. Then he put one of the cups on my head, like a party hat.
I'm sorry.
You're laughing at me?
No, it's just okay. Okay, I am, but just a little bit.
Well, I'm glad that I'm amusing you.
No, it's not that. It's just, I'm picturing that, the image of, oh my God, it's funny. It's cute as all. It's cute.
Cute?
Sure.
You think I probably look cute?
Yeah, what? Huh?
Me. Cute. Well, I'll be.
Scene 8. The apartment. Laughter, but this time it's not from a television set. The laughter belongs to Keeley and David. They're seated on the floor amongst dozens of pictures scattered around about as they munch on ramen noodles.
So you were the one who put food dye in my conditioner?
maybe a little bit.
I thought it was Damien for the longest time. I blame him.
I know. Sorry.
Well, it just goes to show you never really know a guy.
I guess not.
Okay, well, I guess it's only fair to tell you that I am the one who put cold cream in your lotion bottle that one time.
No. Yes. No, that was you? No way.
It was. Every once in a while, I have a good idea.
Yeah. You don't give yourself enough credit sometimes, Keeley. You're a smart girl.
Oh.
What?
It's just I've never heard those words together before.
What do you mean?
I've heard, Keeley, you're really pretty, or Keeley, you're a nice girl. You'll win out sooner or later. I've never heard, Keeley, you're smart. Like, ever.
Well, I just said it, so.
Not even as a joke.
Well, I mean it.
Thanks. David, can I ask you something?
Sure. Anything at all.
Do you think that Damien loved me? No, I'm just asking. I don't feel like you have to answer a certain way to make me happy. I'm just curious, is all.
I don't really know how to answer that.
I mean, don't feel pressured or anything. I just figured that since you were his brother and his roommate and you guys were close and all, that you might know.
I don't. He never really told me. I'm sorry.
Oh. That's okay. Thanks anyways.
I do know that he would have been crazy not to be.
What?
In love with you.
Oh.
The two look at one another in the quiet. Laughter, this time belonging to Cal and Lainey, lights up on the two of them, simultaneous with the current scene upstairs.
What do you mean I'm weird?
Spiritual leader and ridiculously passive-aggressive. I find that ironic.
I'm not.
Sure you are.
I am most certainly not.
Yes, you are.
All right.
See?
So I have faults. All people do.
I know. I just wanted to pick on you. Okay. Ooh, now you tell me one of mine.
What?
Tell me one of mine. I said one of yours. It's only fair. It's like a game.
It doesn't sound like a very fun game to me.
No.
How can a game with personal negative components be fun?
Oh, come on. You do it or I will.
I don't think I feel comfortable.
Stop sticking in your comfort zone. Go beyond that, Putal. Come on. Fine. Suit yourself then.
David and Keeley are now hugging.
Miss him, David.
I know. I do too.
You never even got to tell him how I really felt.
Me neither.
Do you think he knows?
I don't know. Maybe.
You think so?
No.
You're really mad, aren't you?
Yeah.
You didn't used to be like this.
And you didn't used to be so sad and unsure of yourself, so I guess we're even.
I guess so.
Keeley.
Yeah.
Don't be sad. I know that he would not have wanted you to be sad.
It's okay for me to be sad.
No. Because I don't want you to be sad.
David and Keeley kiss. Lainey has now taken to pacing. Cal follows her movements with his head as she rambles.
Sometimes I just talk and talk and talk. I never shut up. I could have my own talk show. David used to say that all the time. Lainey, you could have your own talk show. I think I could. I mean, I can talk about anything. All I do is talk, 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 talk. The mouth keeps moving, even if no one is.
Cal mans up, marching to stop her path and grabbing her suddenly, kisses Lainey. She freezes for a moment. Thinks, and kisses back, stops herself.
Listening.
David also breaks his kiss with Keeley. He's out of breath.
Oh, fuck.
David and Keeley kiss again. Lainey stares at Cal, stunned and unsure. Both say nothing. Blackout. End of Act 1. Act 2, Scene 1, lights up on Cal and Lainey with their respective crates. Lainey wears a winter cap. Cal also wears a goofy winter hat to match Lainey's. Apparently, it was a duo decision.
We must look pretty ridiculous.
Do we care? Do you care?
A little.
Oh, hi, they.
What if someone from my congregation walks by?
Oh, come on.
They might.
Look at it this way. Do you really want someone in your posse who hangs out in alleys?
That's not what I meant, nor is it what I'm worried about.
Worried? That they'll see you with me?
No, no. That's not it at all. Not you, I swear. Not you at all.
Well, then stop worrying. Loosen up a little.
I'll have you know that I am very loose.
Yeah, right.
I'm wearing this hat, aren't I? I am.
Prove it.
All right. How?
Let go. Just let go.
Let go of what exactly?
Everything. Just shake it all out and let loose.
Says a girl who's been stuck in the same spot for nearly a month.
One, unfair. Two, location has nothing to do with it. Do something out of character for once.
I've already done plenty out of character as far as you're concerned.
Oh yeah, sitting on a crate totally qualifies you for the unique club.
Not what I meant.
Still, I tried your Shamarah. You try something of mine.
Like what?
David! Huh?
Come again?
That's what I want you to try. Oh, come on, Cal, just give it a try. Hop up here and just let loose.
This isn't at all what I had in mind.
Roll with the punches, man. Live a little, laugh a little. Do something instead of just standing there watching.
All right.
Cal takes a moment before stepping on top of the crate, looking a bit less exuberant than Lainey did.
David.
Oh, come on, like this. David!
David.
Louder, so he can hear you. David!
David, if it isn't much trouble,
Are you serious right now? Come on.
I'm just not cut out for this sort of thing. I'm not cut out this kind of person. I'll never get it. You know, I prefer to...
Lainey grabs either side of Cal's face and kisses him, then breaks away. Cal faces outward, way more confident than before.
David!
There it is! David!
David!
Little more gut! David!
David!
Yes! David!
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 David! David! Oh, man. Awesome. Yeah?
It's getting late. I should turn in soon.
Okay.
All right. Oh, it'll get cold. Do you want me to get you a coat or something?
No, I'm fine.
All right. You could always come upstairs. It's warm up here. I'll let you in.
That's okay.
All right. Well, maybe if you get hungry.
I'm fine.
All right. There's a diner around the corner. I'm sure if you left for just an hour, David wouldn't mind.
I can't.
You can't. You can come right back after.
I can't, okay?
All right.
David could come out. Today might be the day that he decides to poke his head out of the window and I can't miss it.
All right. Do you owe him a favor or something? Is that why you're doing this?
I'm his best friend.
Lainey.
That's what friends are supposed to do.
What definition of friend are you following?
Mine.
Of course. Now it's all coming together.
Cal examines Lainey's guitar case. He comes to the part that has a large DB scribbled on it.
Oh. Oh. That's, Damien. Makes sense. What was he like? What kind of person was he? He sounds like a great guy. Lainey.
Yeah?
You were in love with Damien, weren't you? I'm sorry, Lainey.
What time is it?
I didn't know if I
did. It's late.
What?
You have work in the morning, right?
Lainey, what's wrong?
You should go inside.
Why are you doing this?
I'm not doing anything.
Do you want to talk about it?
There's nothing to talk about.
Nothing to talk about, but you just said...
Forget it!
Lainey, it's okay if you want to talk about it.
There is nothing to talk about!
But you...
No, I'm not! I just said I'm not, so lay off, please!
All right.
Silence. Cal turns to leave, freezes. For once, he cannot retreat and turns back around.
I kissed you, Lainey.
Cal, please.
I made a decision. Irrational as it was, and I kissed you.
You shouldn't be out here.
That may not seem like a huge thing to you, but for me to be able to do that, it's a big deal.
It doesn't have to be.
This could be good, Lainey. You listen to me. You really listen to me. You listen to what I have to say. Like you force me to say things so you have something to listen to. You're a wonderful person. You're a beautiful person.
Oh, jeez.
Do you ever hear that? Have you ever heard that? If you have, it's not nearly enough. Lainey, jeez, I don't even know your last name, but Lainey, you're beautiful.
Oh, please don't.
You're beautiful. You're beautiful. You're beautiful.
Cal!
You are the most remarkable person that I've ever met. You're not the kind of person I ever expected to meet. You're just you. And you're teaching me to be myself for the first time. And I never knew what it meant to be me, to be Cal. But with you, I'm starting to. And with you, it'll become so much more clear. Look, now you've got me talking and I can't stop. Look what you've helped me do.
I didn't want to do anything.
That's exactly my point. Everything you say or do sticks with me. Even the things that you don't say.
All I do is...
Lainey, look at me. I kissed you. I meant it. You kissed me. Did you mean it?
I was just proving a point.
You won't give me a chance. Why won't you give me a chance? Why? What did I do? What did I ever do to you? I didn't do anything to deserve this. I just walked outside my apartment. Why did I ever leave my apartment? I should have just stayed inside. I should have just never talked to you. I should have never kissed you. I shouldn't have done any of that. It's not me. This isn't me. I should have never. Oh, well, I am suddenly very tired. Goodbye, Lainey. All right.
Cal exits, leaving Lainey alone. Scene 2. Lights up on Lainey alone, still sitting on the crate.
Dave! Me again? Well, me still? We really need to talk, buddy. Dave, I messed up. I mean, I really messed up. I really hurt him, Dave. It's just... I'd really appreciate having my best bud around to talk to, you know? Just like old times. I really miss the old times. I'd give anything to have those again. Just back to the way things were. I like the way things were. Can't we go back to that? Back to the whole pals thing? You and me. Come on, Dave. It's getting cold. I'm tired. I smell. Why don't you just throw down the key? You know what? Fuck you, man. You just fuck you, some friend you are. After all I've fucking done for you, after everything we've been through together, we're best friends, Dave. Aren't we best friends? What? You got something to say? Well, go ahead. You act like everything doesn't matter. How can nothing else matter? How can you just choose not to feel? How do you do that? Please tell me and I'll do it.
Nothing. Lainey moves to leave. She stops after a few steps and returns to her initial position.
You don't have to be up there. You choose to be. You choose to shut yourself off from everyone, just like you chose not to, you chose to lock yourself in there, and you chose not to call me back, even though I must have called you a dozen fucking times, just like you chose not to go to my shows before this all even happened. You know, right now, you're choosing to be an ass, and I am sick of it. I'm sick of waiting around like some dumb fuck. You can rot up there for all I care.
Lainey storms off. Silence. Emptiness. A few long seconds pass. Lainey reemerges, now surprisingly calm. She sits, quiet.
You'll come out when you're ready. I'll be here.
Scene 3. David's apartment, morning. David enters wearing a robe and mug in hand. Today just might be a good day. Turns the television on. No laughter. It's the news. He walks toward the kitchen nook. He prepares breakfast, but it's with two plates. Just as he turns around, Lainey pokes her head in through the window.
Jesus Christ!
Hey, buddy!
Oh, God.
How's it going?
Who does that?
What?
How did you do that?
What?
That.
Oh, mad skills.
Wait, what are you trying to do right now?
Oh, I didn't mean to scare you. I'm just tired of waiting. Didn't you hear me yelling?
I was busy, all right?
Well, that's cool. People get busy. So what are you up to, man?
Breakfast.
That's exciting.
Loads.
Jeez, you get scared easy.
Yeah, sorry if I wasn't expecting someone to pop through my window.
I said I was sorry.
You're lucky you didn't fall.
I just wanted to see if you were all right.
Listen, Lainey, is there something you want?
Me?
Yeah, I mean, you did just practically climb up the side of my building. I figure there must be a reason.
Well, there isn't.
You have to want something. You've been outside of my building every day for God knows how long.
There's no reason.
You wait all day, even though I told you it won't pay off.
I'm just, you see.
You scaled my building.
You would have done the same for
me. You're crazy. Why would that even cross your mind?
Because, David,
there's no reason that you would go through all of this. Like, none whatsoever.
I'm trying to tell you, but
you have killed yourself.
You just won't listen, and
why
I
would you
try...
do something like that? I mean, you
David, I just... David, I... Because I love
why
you!
You
I love you! Oh.
Is that Lainey? It sounded like her. Oh, hi!
Oh.
Lainey.
No, it's okay, I get it.
Is everything okay?
Yeah, everything's fine. I'll just leave you guys alone. Nice seeing you again, Keeley.
Yeah, you look great.
Lainey, hey, please don't go like this.
I don't blame you. I wouldn't want to leave here either.
Lainey, just wait, please.
I hope you told her I said hi.
I did not really have time.
Last night was great.
It was. It was something.
Yeah, I wasn't expecting that, like, at all. I was thinking that maybe today after my audition, we could get together and...
I don't, that's not the best idea.
Something wrong?
Don't you feel even a little bit guilty?
Do you?
Yeah. I mean, of course I do. You were dating my brother. You loved my brother.
I do. It's hard to explain. I mean, he's gone, David.
Yeah, I know that. That's not the point. It's only part of it. I am not my brother, Keeley.
I wasn't asking you to be.
But you are. You're pretty much asking me to replace Damien in some way. You were dating my brother, Keeley, and I just slept with you. We just slept together. How is that okay?
David, please stop it. Please.
I shouldn't have kissed you. I shouldn't have even let you inside.
I don't get it. I thought that we were okay. I thought that we were more than okay.
We are. It's this that is not.
I like you. You have been so supportive.
I have no idea how you can possibly be so blasé about all of this.
I don't even know what that is!
I mean, how could you be so stupid?
I'll just go.
Keeley gets her jacket and puts it on before moving to the door.
David?
Huh?
I always knew that you did that food dye thing.
Keeley exits. David turns around. Phil comes in through the open door. He has a beer in one hand and chips in the other.
What's Princess McSlutbag's problem? She looks a bit less sparkles and rainbows all of a sudden.
It's not the time, Phil, please.
Always the time, Dave. I brought you some brewskis over if you wish to partake. Friday's word. Boom, got it.
I really don't feel like it right now.
You don't feel like it? Man, since when?
I just don't, okay?
Since when do you feel like not drinking? Holy shit. Did you hit that? Oh, shit, man! You hit that? Oh, nice!
Just, Phil, come on, please.
Survey says? Fuck yeah, man! You got with that. High five! All right. Keeley Perdue, formerly known as Keeley Reynolds. Serious upgrade, man. When's she coming back for an encore?
She's not.
Well, why the hell not?
I think it's obvious why it's not.
Man, that's stupid. So she had a thing with your brother. He ain't in the picture no more. Go for it, man. Full speed ahead. Woo woo!
Phil moves to open a beer for David.
You know, I wish I had your balls, man.
Huh?
To not give a shit.
I give a shit.
Yeah. Right, dude.
No,
I mean, come on. You say what you're thinking and you don't let it affect anyone or anything affect you. You've been that way forever. No matter what happens, Damien dying, your dad dying, Sandra dumping you, you just don't care. You're still the same old Phil. You never change. Always the same. Plenty of people hate you for it, and you don't care.
People hate me?
You just don't care. A few beers and a salty snack and you're back on a roll. You do the whole one-night stand thing, and you don't care that in the end, you're alone. I mean, you just live day by day. Like, if you're all alone, I mean, what the hell? Just give me a beer, man.
I always thought that people thought I was funny.
What?
I care. I just don't advertise it, all right? Because if I did, everyone would be freaked out because, oh no, Phil's showing his feelings. He's the funny guy. How fucked up. Just because I don't go crying or locking myself in an apartment, just fuck it.
Phil, I didn't mean it.
It's cool. I don't want to be alone, man.
You seem to be doing just fine.
Yeah, I do, huh?
Damn it. Why does this keep happening?
He looks to the discarded bag of chips and thought. Takes one. Looks at it. Puts it in his mouth. Crunch. Scene 4. The street. Lainey sits on her crate with a sandwich in her lap.
You know what I don't understand? It's just cheese. It's like it's cheese with holes. Who wants to pay just as much money for a full slice of American cheese as a slice of Swiss, which, when you add in holes, probably only amounts to half an American cheese slice. But you're paying the same amount of money. You're getting ripped off. And since when do you pay for things with holes in them? If you have socks with holes, you throw them out. If you got a bag with a hole and it can't hold anything, so you throw it out. A cat with a hole, you bury it in the backyard. And a person with a hole, then you got an issue. With holes, you normally feel bad and feel the need to fix them. But for some reason, cheese with holes is totally okay. Nobody wants to fix the cheese. Nobody pities it. In the end, it all ends up on the same Kaiser roll. Wow. I have no idea what the fuck I'm talking about.
You still out there? Go away. Smells like failure outside.
Lainey doesn't respond. A few moments pass, and Phil rushes on to the stage.
What do you think you're doing?
What?
I yell at you, you yell back at me, I insult you, you twist my words around, and then insult my ass. I mean, that's how this works.
Sorry.
Don't be sorry, just fucking do it. Now let's try this again.
Phil exits. A few moments pass.
Go away!
Why don't you make me?
Well, I'll come down there and make you.
Well, why don't you then?
Maybe I will.
Okay.
Oh, hey, my ugly meter went off. Looks like Lainey's here.
Oh, yeah, well, you're such a... I think you're a, Oh, I'm sorry, Phil.
No. What is your deal?
I can't do this.
But we always do this.
I tried, but I can't.
Fuck you.
Why did I ever think that I could do this, any of this?
I don't know. You're an idiot.
Yeah. Yeah, I am.
No. I set you up with that one. This is our thing. You have to do our thing.
I'm so stupid.
No. You're going to do this. You have to do this. It's our thing. That's what we got. This is all I've got that I can depend on. So we're going to do this right. We're going to do this right. You got me?
Yeah, I got you. I get you.
Yeah, I get you.
Chode.
Okay, there we go. Uh-huh.
Phil moogies Lainey and exits. Scene 5. David's apartment. An insistent knocking, which drives Dave to roll out from under the blankets on his couch.
David, open this door. David, open up now.
David moves to the door sluggishly. He opens it.
Keeley called me crying.
Did she?
Yeah, she did. And Fallon wasn't pleased.
Oh, no.
Isn't the time to be snide, David?
It's too late to be anything else, Dan.
So not only are you avoiding signing the papers, but you're also making girls cry?
Oh God, Daniel.
Don't use the Lord's name in vain. You said you would.
As I recall, I deliberately avoided any form of response.
Damn it, Dave, this is about Aiden. A little boy. Show some compassion.
I can't do this right now, Dan.
You always can't do this, Dave.
It's not right.
How is it not right if it's what Damien wanted?
There's a lot of things Damien wanted that I managed to mess up.
I don't know what you mean, but that's not the point. Just sign the papers and give them to me.
No. I'm sorry, just no.
Dave.
Listen to me, Daniel. Every time I look at that kid, I see Damien. His eyes, his hair, his face, him. Every time I look at you, I see him. Every time I look in the mirror, I can't take that, Dan. Please don't make me. You do it.
Damien said...
Want what is best for his child, and that's you and Fallon.
I won't.
Screw whatever sense of loyalty you have, Dan, and just whip out a pen and do it. You do it because I won't.
The will said that...
Yeah, fuck your papers. Fuck... You're self-righteous. Just fuck all of that.
You're gonna regret this.
I'm not you, Dan.
I'll sign these, and you'll regret it for the rest of your life.
Go away.
You haven't even seen him.
Just go away.
He looks so much like him, but he's just like you. Aiden is just like you, and you don't even know it. You'll never know it because you're too scared or maybe you're too hurt. I don't know.
Leave now.
You're too something. Afraid you'll fail or afraid you'll lose, but did you ever stop to think that he might be exactly what you need? You're just what each other needs.
I won't ask you again.
You won't even know until you give him a chance.
Go away now.
No, I won't. Not this time, David. I am sick and tired of being pushed around and told what to do. I am right. I am right about this. I'm right about everything, and you know it. And you're going to listen to me. Really listen to me.
Back off, man.
If you don't step up and do this, I'll call social services.
Yeah, yeah. Right, okay, Dan.
I'm serious. I won't get your groceries. I won't help you pay rent. I won't do shit. I'll have mom and dad cut you off completely. I'll call social services.
Be quiet.
I'll see to it that they come up here and do whatever they do with deadbeat dad.
Shut up!
David shoves Daniel into the wall, hard enough for him to go down. Both brothers are stunned. Silence. No one moves right away.
Oh my God, Dan, are you okay? I'm so sorry. Dan, I didn't mean it. It was an accident. Just I didn't know that. Dan, I really didn't. Danny.
Daniel exits, closing the door behind him. This leaves David by himself in the now empty apartment, all alone. Scene 6. Lights up on Lainey. Daniel rushes onto the street, hurries right past her. He stops, backtracks. He stands behind her but says nothing.
You look awful.
Yeah, you too.
I look how I always look.
Whatever you say.
Daniel moves to leave.
I don't know why I'm doing this anymore.
That'll happen.
Daniel sits beside Lainey. It's quiet.
Dan?
Hmm?
He's never going to let me up, is he?
Maybe. No. Probably not. He's never going to sign those papers, is he?
Maybe. No. Probably not.
She rests against Daniel as he hugs her.
This sucks.
Yes, it most certainly does.
Scene 7. An insistent knock on the door. David walks over and opens it to reveal the infamous Fallon, cell phone tucked between her shoulder and ear.
Hello?
Hey.
David leaves her at the door before plopping right back on the couch and resumes watching his television show. Fallon remains in the doorway, still dominant, but refuses to invite herself inside. She hangs up the phone.
How are you? Nice day outside.
I guess.
The place looks, well, it looks, listen, David, I'm really awful at this whole making casual conversation and coddling bull. Can I just come inside?
Fallon, if you want to come inside, you just can. Don't wait for me to invite you in. You never did before.
Right. You see, David, that's why I always liked you. You and I are always on the same page.
She now gets a better look of the place for the first time in a while. For a moment, she looks disgusted. Then careful, then sickened again, then serious.
You like me?
Yeah, why?
No reason.
Right. I actually came to pick something up.
Of course.
Daniel forgot to pick it up earlier.
Yeah, it's in the trash. I didn't think you'd be back for it after what happened. I'll just get it.
No, it's fine. I've got it.
She moves to the garbage can, crouches, and begins to sort through everything as she digs.
Do you usually dig through other people's trash?
I'm a paralegal. Stuff like this gets me through the first 2 years of my internship, not to mention my first date with your brother.
What do you mean?
Well, he used to come into my bookstore every day just to look at me. He'd never say a word. He'd just walk by with books in his hand. Completely random. Nothing that someone like Danny would actually read. Finally, he got the courage to talk to me and ask me out for coffee. I said I would do it in exchange for one thing.
What?
I wanted to look inside his backpack. And he let me. It had all the information that I needed to make an informed decision.
Which was?
Well, they were all the normal things, like water bottle, his textbooks, pictures, a wallet. But there was also another thing.
What?
Receipts.
Receipts?
One for every day that he'd been in the bookstore with at least two purchases on each. Apparently he did it in some sort of elaborate ruse to be less obvious.
So books were the reason you and Dan started dating. I should have guessed.
No. Every time Danny came to the store, he spent well over his means at the time just to look at me. He gave all that he had just to do one simple, innocent little thing. I think that any woman would be lucky to have someone like that in her life. Don't you?
No, I mean, he sounds like a stalker to me. I never knew my brother did anything like that.
There's a lot about Danny you don't know. Oh, here it is. You still have time to sign this. Say, David, I heard this really funny joke today after court, and I thought you might like it. It goes like this. This guy...
Because when do you tell jokes?
I don't. Not usually. I just thought of you when I heard this one.
Why?
I don't know. I just did. There doesn't need to be a reason.
No, I know. With you, there's always a reason.
What?
With you, there's always a reason. Both you and Dan. That's why you get along so well, I guess. I mean, you both know everything and what's best for everybody. It seems like you guys do it like every moment that you possibly can, just so you can be right and high and mighty. Dan didn't used to be like that, but since you, it's always Fallon said this and Fallon says that. Do you ever let him have a single independent thought in his head? Do you need to have control over, like, absolutely everything?
I never said I did.
Well, you sure act like it. Do you ever think that the reason things with Dan and I are the way they are is because of you?
That's not true, and you know it.
Oh, it is true. Ever since you came into the picture...
He what? He's got his own opinion, which is different from yours?
Yeah, your opinion.
And so what? At least now he's not staying quiet and rolling over just because you don't want to deal with him. At least now you have to look at him and can't push him aside like he means nothing.
I don't have time to deal with this.
You have plenty of time. Fuck David. You have all the time in the world. You just don't want to deal with anyone. Not your brother, not me, not Lainey. For God's sakes. That girl's been downstairs for God knows how long, and all you can do is stay up here all cooped up and hating the whole world. Newsflash, David, we didn't kill Damien.
Stop it.
None of us did anything wrong except move on with our lives, which is exactly what people do when they're in situations like this. Forgive us for trying to live our lives and not insisting on shutting off from everyone and everything or locking ourselves up in an apartment. And God forbid that I make your brother happy and that we get married. You don't like me. I get it, David. I got the hint. I refuse to apologize for who I am. You need to get over your this need for isolation or you don't need anyone. Not me, not Danny, Lainey will wise up and we will leave too. And soon all you'll have is...
Below the doorway, eating chips.
Sour cream and onion, anyone?
Him!
Fallon moves to the door and brushes past Phil. She exits.
What's Queen Bitch Esquire's problem?
Scene 8. Lights up on an empty crate in the alley. Lainey is gone. A few seconds pass. She's not there. Fallon strides onto the street. A few seconds later, Phil comes running out after her, a bag of chips still in hand.
Hey, okay, wait up. Yo, hey, wait up. Wait up, super bitch. Yeah, you. Queen Bitch Esquire. Come on. Richie McBitch Bitch.
She turns around sharply. Phil takes a few cautionary steps back.
Oh, there we go. Finally.
I have a name, Phil.
I know, dude. It's just, I've been calling you that for so long. I just kind of forgot it in the heat of the moment.
Fallon, in disgust, turns around and begins to pick up some of the mess Lainey left, which is further away from Phil.
Oh, come on. No fair. You can't hold that against me. It's not like I'm the only fucking one doing it. Everybody else called you that, so it was an honest mistake.
Fallon now moves to exit completely.
All right. You got me. Party foul on Phil. Foul on Pima. My bad. I didn't mean to upset you. Want a chip?
No, thanks. That's okay.
You pissed off at the Dave Meister?
Excuse me?
It's okay. Everybody gets pissed off at the Dave Meister sometimes. But look at this way. At least you're not living with him. I mean, I used to do that all through college and then getting men over here. But I'm the kind of guy who needs his own space and freedom, you know? So I moved out.
Phil?
Yeah?
You moved across the hall.
Ah, come on. Location has nothing to do with it. God, you and Danny Boy hating on me. You're both really meant for each other, you know that?
all right, I'll stop. It wasn't my intention to.
What?
My bad.
Oh, yeah, all right. Hey, I get you. Hey, super bitch ain't so bad.
Thank you.
I don't get why Dave hates you so damn much, but yeah.
Thank you, Philip.
Fallon returns to her cleaning, and Phil just watches.
Why did you come here anyway?
I wanted to give David one last chance to sign the papers for Aiden.
Danny Boy usually does that.
Well, not today.
Oh. Oh, man. You know what you need? You need a good laugh. Where's Crazy Lainey? That girl is so berserk. Always been that way. Used to make fun of her all the time. Where is she? Well, she's usually here.
Not today.
Oh. Oh. Oh, shit, man.
You see? That I understand.
Everything's gone to hell.
Seems like it. Unless you have any bright ideas.
Not unless you want to catapult the damn kid through the window.
That's it. Phil, you're brilliant.
Oh, I have never heard that before.
I'll be back in an hour.
Fallon exits, leaving Phil alone.
Oh, Christ. I really hope she isn't going to catapult the fucking kid.
Scene 9. David in his apartment. He has a blanket that has been twisted into a makeshift rope. He studies it and then tests the hold by pulling on it. He holds his breath for a long time, trying to see what it'd be like, testing the waters. He stands and gets a chair. Pushing it to the middle of the room, he slings the makeshift rope over a part of the ceiling and stands below it, continuing to examine, and he ties it around his neck. Before stepping, he uses his hand to pull test it again, just to see what it would be like. Honestly, he's a bit cowardly about the whole thing. He holds his breath again. Perhaps he can do it without a tool. A soft knock at the door. David initially doesn't budge. He is set on not answering it. A pause. Another quiet knock. David crosses his arms over his chest in a stubborn challenge against the invisible force. Another knock. Finally, he gives in and moves to the door, only after pulling the makeshift rope away and tossing it on the couch.
Doesn't anybody listen around here? I said leave me alone.
The door opens to reveal Aiden, 6 years old, a determined look on his face and a knapsack on his back. He is holding a teddy bear in his hand. David at first is stunned into silence.
Uncle David, it's me, Aiden. You remember me, don't you?
What? Yeah. Aiden, of course I do. Where did Fallon go?
David looks out the door. Aiden cranes his head up as David stands over him.
I don't know.
She brought you, didn't she?
Yeah, then she lost me. She told me to wait downstairs, but she took too long.
Yeah, she was too busy on me, I guess.
She yelled at you? Did you do something wrong?
No, I...
David manages to peel himself away from the door and looks down at his nephew.
Probably.
You don't come see me anymore.
To be honest, kiddo, I really haven't seen anyone lately. Lately, everybody comes to visit me, whether I want them to or not. Seems to be the new trend.
Well, I came to visit you. Do you not want me to?
No, Aiden, that is not true.
Did I do something wrong?
No, of course not. You didn't do anything wrong. It's not then, like that at all.
Then why don't you come see me anymore? Are you mad at me?
No, I'm not mad. I'm not anything at you. I don't know how to make you to understand, right? Get in here. Come on. You hungry? You silly chicken noodle?
Yes, please.
All right. Yes, please. Wow, I bet you're a big hit in
first grade?
Yeah, you are acting like a real gentleman, huh? All the girls are probably crazy about you, huh?
Yuck.
What? Trust me, kiddo. You say yuck now, but in a couple of years, you're going to be all about them. You're going to think about them 24/7, and they're going to get you in all sorts of trouble.
That'll never happen. Uncle David?
Yep.
Why don't you leave your room?
I don't know.
You have to know. You're thinking it.
Yeah. I can't put it into words.
Well, put it in a box and then give it to me.
No. That's not what I meant.
What do you mean?
I'm not sure. Here, okay?
David hands him a few colored pens and a piece of the newspaper.
Just color.
But you're a grown-up. You have to know. And this is just a crossword.
Hey, color. God, where is she?
Is it a secret?
Yes. So it's a secret. So
top secret? Mm-hmm. Like the FBY?
Yeah, exactly like that. Like the FBY.
I made that up, Uncle David. There's no such thing as the FBY.
Oh, God. Okay, look.
You just fibbed.
No, I didn't.
Fib.
Okay, I did. I fibbed, and that was wrong. Now, Aiden, I am so sorry that I fibbed. Don't you ever do that, all right? Just tell a fib.
I don't, and I won't. Okay. But now you gotta tell me why you stay up here. It's yucky.
Oh, thank you so much.
Why do you stay up here all by yourself?
It's complicated.
What's complicated?
It means it's difficult. It's messy.
Can't you clean it up? That's what I do with my room when it gets messy. Fallon makes murals. I don't get dessert.
Oh, see that? Yeah, that's not really the same thing.
Oh. Do you want to play a game?
Sure. What'll it be? I think I've got an old deck of Uno cards around here somewhere.
Let's play Uncle David Answers Aiden's Questions.
Oh, God.
David plops down on the couch, defeated, his face in his hands. Aiden immediately stops bouncing and is still. Silence. Aiden slowly sits down beside David. Aiden tries to figure out what to do next. He eventually settles on wrapping his arms around David in a hug. David reciprocates. It seems to come naturally to him, oddly enough.
I'm sorry I made you sad.
It's okay. You didn't make me sad.
But you are sad, aren't you?
Sometimes, sure. I mean, I doubt a big guy like you ever gets sad, though, huh?
Sometimes. Just not all the time. Like you. It's okay to be sad. Just not all the time. It's also okay for boys to cry, just not in front of girls who they like but haven't spoken to yet.
Yeah, that's probably true.
My daddy told me that. Doesn't it bother you?
What?
Being all by yourself. You're sad because my daddy isn't coming back. It's okay, Uncle David. It's okay to be sad.
A knock at the door.
Oh, thank God, that's fine. Okay, come on, big guy. Time to go.
But I'm not finished coloring.
Come on, up on your feet.
Uncle David, let's play cops and robbers.
She is not the most patient of people, okay?
You can be a cop if you want. I'll be the bad guy.
Aiden, you don't want her to leave you here.
We can play Uno instead if you want.
Aiden.
Let's watch a movie.
Listen to me.
Let's wrestle.
Listen.
I'm about to...
Just stop it! Stay...
Quiet. Except for the knocking. David hoists Aiden into the air and over his shoulder like a bag of potatoes. The little boy just hangs there once again, obedient for his favorite uncle. David makes the full trek to the door and opens it, revealing Fallon. Though annoyed from earlier, there is a hint of amusement in her eyes at the scene before her.
Working out?
Clever. Here you go.
Wait! My teddy!
David sighs, but after a split second's thought, he walks back into the room toward the teddy, with Aiden still slung over his shoulder. He bends over, picks it up, and looks the boy back to the door and Fallon. He holds it up for Aiden to take it.
That's okay. You can have it.
David groans and sets Aiden down beside Fallon.
You're bare, Aiden.
No, you can keep it. He gives good hugs.
Do I look like I need a hug?
Yes. And it's okay if you need one. You're still a boy. Teddy hates giving hugs, but he gives them anyway because he's a nice bear, even though he's grumpy.
Oh, okay.
Daddy even said grumpy, mumpy bears need hugs sometimes. And Uncle Daniel says you're the grumpiest, mumpiest bear of all.
Ah, he does.
Yep. But we all love you anyway. Me most.
Uncle Daniel says I look like a bear.
Uh-huh. I don't think you look like a bear, though.
You don't?
Nuh-uh.
Okay. What do you think I look like?
Me. But that's okay. We're supposed to look alike. We used to spend a lot of time together.
Is that how it works?
Supposedly.
Someday, I'm going to be just like you.
You know, maybe you're the one who looks like me, huh, kiddo?
Maybe, but you can't prove it.
It's got you there.
Thanks.
Come on, Aiden.
Like me, huh?
Yep, except I still go outside sometimes. Bye, Uncle David. I love you.
Fallon and Aiden exit down the hall. David can't help but glance into the hallway, watching Aiden leave.
Oh, boy.
Scene 10. David's apartment. David alone, pacing in the midst of making an important decision. Finally, he makes up his mind and he marches to the door, opening it as if to leave. This reveals Daniel, hand raised as if about to knock.
Oh, God!
Holy crap.
I was
just...
You see,
said,
I was...
No, Daniel,
damn door! Daniel,
hey,
Hi.
Dan, are you all right?
Fallon brought these home. Before I signed them, I just wanted to give you one last chance.
Okay, let me see him.
Damn it, Dave! Come on, you didn't even hear... What?
I said okay. Let me take a look.
Really? Oh, wow, that's great! Really, David? Gosh, that's wonderful. You're taking the first step? Oh, wow. You won't regret it. I can't wait to tell Fallon that you actually finally read them.
You have to give me the papers before I can read them, though, Danny.
Oh, shit. Right. Here.
David sits on the couch, and Daniel sneaks inside, reading over his shoulder.
So, you're really thinking about doing this, huh?
Yep.
Scared?
Shitless.
Don't worry. I'm told that's normal. I felt the same way when Fallon proposed to me.
Figures.
So what? A wise older brother once told me that everyone has their own way of dealing with things.
Really? This brother sounds really smart.
Nah, he is. Sometimes.
I get it. Okay.
15% of the time.
I get it, Daniel.
Which, looking back on it, is out of 100%, so it's really not that great, respectively.
I get it, Daniel. Okay.
Sorry.
You give a guy one compliment on his attempt at a joke, and he just runs with it for, like, 5 years.
Say, David. Tonight, Fallon and I are going out to dinner. Apparently it's some kind of pre-rehearsal dinner thing, and we'd love it if you could make it.
You want me to go?
What? Of course I do. We all do.
Will Aiden?
Yeah. He'll be looking forward to seeing you. It's been a while. If you go.
Not as long as you think.
What?
No, nothing.
Oh, Keeley told me to give you this. It's a food dye. I don't understand it, but then again, I don't really understand much of anything that comes out of that girl's head.
Thank you.
You should give her a call.
I will, okay?
Daniel turns to leave.
Dan, I'm really sorry about
earlier. Hey, man, it's all right. We're brothers. We'll just say it was you catching up on all the roughhousing that we couldn't accomplish back when I was little because you were too busy. Okay. Thanks for penciling me in.
Yeah, okay.
What's so funny?
Nothing. I just...
What?
I think you tried to make a joke. It must be going around.
Hmm?
Earlier, you know what? Never mind. It's okay.
Well, I hope to see you at dinner.
Daniel turns to leave.
Dan, thank you for everything.
Don't worry about it. You're my brother. I've read that's how it's supposed to be.
David smiles. Daniel smiles back.
I'm thinking of going darker again. I know. I said that it was too dark before, but it actually grew on me. Get it? Grew? Like hair, it grew. Wow, I made a joke. Can you imagine that? Well, okay, as I was saying, I know I was skeptical before, but I actually started to like it. Funny how that works out, huh?
Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Norman? Norman, listen to me. I want those files on my desk tomorrow at the absolute latest. Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Shh. I don't care what your excuse is. I want the files on my desk tomorrow. All right? We're going to get started on this case bright and early. Uh-huh. No. Absolutely not. I have a very important meeting tonight. No, it definitely cannot be rescheduled. Uh-huh. Goodbye, Norman.
It is just so strange how differently things can turn out. I used to be so scared of it. I used to panic. Can you imagine that? But now I know better. How I know, I don't have any idea, but I do. And there's no need to absolutely freak out. It's just a part of, silly bee, you have to go, don't you? Okay, well, here is your change.
Change out of that right now.
I told you, Fallon, I don't look good in these things.
I happen to think you look very dashing.
You're teasing me.
Am not, and very suave.
Okay, I get the point.
Oh, did you tie this yourself? A master of many talents.
Fallon.
I love you. I love you.
Love you too.
As they embrace, Fallon daringly slings her arm around him and gives his thumb a little squeeze. Phil appears, back at his old bar, trying to pick up the ladies.
Hey!
Hey, good looking.
I love you too.
Hey there, baby. Gonna buy you a drink?
Okay, that's enough of that.
Well, how about you buy me a drink?
I met this guy recently. Well, re-met, actually. It's kind of weird how it all happened. Out of nowhere. You know, like these things usually do. Strange.
What about you?
He has a kid, a little boy. Not his brother's. He took him in. I think he'll be a good dad. I mean, he's a great guy, even if he doesn't know it yet.
Give me a bud.
Now you get out of that suit and get into something more comfortable.
Oh, it was actually starting to grow on me.
Do you actually mean that?
No.
Then go change.
I really love you.
I know.
You know that this is an odd call. I realize this. I realized it the moment I dialed this number. I actually hung up 4 times before I let the call go through. Yes, that was me hanging up. I apologize, but listen. The least you could do is listen. My name is Caputal. I live in apartment 13B at... Will you listen?
I don't think that love is something that you can predict.
There was a young woman outside here, and I'm worried. She's not here anymore. No, you don't understand. She was here for a very long time. It wouldn't be like her to just wander off for no reason. No.
It kind of just sneaks up on you.
You're not listening to me. Will you just... I realize you probably get a bunch of calls like this, and this particular one probably sounds extremely silly given the context, but you don't understand. I don't even understand. Hello?
Wham! Just like that.
Do not hang up on me. Don't you do that. This is important. I am asking you. No, I am begging you from the heart of one man to another. Just take a moment of your time. I realize that you are a very busy man and there are loads of other calls, but you have to try. Please.
It's kind of funny how these things work out.
Well, whenever you get the time to get around to it.
Another bud.
Can you fix this?
I need glue.
Oh, you've made a mess of things.
I tend to.
Fallon approaches to assist Daniel. Phil, meanwhile, notices a beautiful woman who catches his eye and actually makes him drop his facade.
Whoa.
Stand upright.
I want you.
Not like that.
I want something.
Look at me. Don't look down. Work with me.
I'm a politician.
Aiden rushes in. Fallon picks him up and hands him over to Daniel.
Oh, no.
Hi.
There we go.
Have a nice day. Remember, anything can happen.
Lainey strides across from offstage, a sandwich and soda in hand. She didn't leave at all. Apparently, she just needed a lunch break. Now everything is right with the world, and Cal sees her.
David! 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 I'm back! And I'm not going anywhere until you throw those keys down.
Beautiful.
We're meeting my brother at dinner.
This could be easy or hard, your choice.
We are?
Leave or stay.
Stay?
What's it gonna be?
He'll be there. I know it.
I'm not leaving.
Maybe something different, or maybe the same old thing.
Oh, I can play Hey There, Delilah if you want.
Throw the
damn keys
down.
It'll be just fine.
Lainey realizes her hands are messy from the sandwich. Searches for something to wipe her hands. Turns to leave to fetch a napkin. Just then a set of keys are thrown down, just missing her. She bends down, picks them up. Feels them in her hands. Jingles. It's pretty neat. She smiles.
It will.
Blackout.